We're at the ferry terminal, but we don't want to go to Alaska, so Brenda's gone to look for where we go to go down to Port Hardy in BC. They do like their totem poles in BC. It looks like this one's come to life. So Brenda sweet talked the customs people and they let us park over here at the ferry terminal. They said we can leave the trailer unhitched, go see the town, as long as we're back by 10 o'clock. We'll use the washrooms, they close at midnight, but we have to be up tomorrow morning early, not only for the ferry, but for other things too. Graffiti artists have been busy here. It's about 6 o'clock in the morning and everybody's waiting now for the ferry so we could get the boarding call. And then we'll be on our way. This shows the passage that we're going to take on the ship. It goes from Prince Rupert through the inner channels. Some of the points of interest over here. Of course, we can't bore you with all of them. Here's the first one. And the second one. Okay, we're exiting the ferry. Just gonna take it casually because it's bumpy normally and very narrow. And the rain seems to have stopped, which is a good thing. And we're now in Port Hardy on Vancouver Island on the Pacific. Well, we had another host, and it's another horse farm. And another retired couple. So now we have the trailer reversed in one of their side entrances, I believe. Oh, and there are some horses. They're just minding their own business, not worried about us. And we are by just south of Campbell River in BC. Our morning view this morning. See, I'm being watched over there by the local residents. So this is our neighbors. There's Brenda having a chat. So Brenda was driving and she spotted this big red bus with fish and chips. And so she's decided that's what we're gonna have for dinner. She's off to buy some. If they make fish and chips out of salmon, I've never heard of that. But hey, we'll see what she brings back. This is what some of the beach houses look like, or beach cottages look like, along the beach. The local flower store forgot to put their produce away. Went for a cup of coffee. And what's that now happening? Somebody's got their head in the stall and is eating the flowers. I hope he pays for them. Some of the mundane things you have to attend to when you're doing a long trip like this is, of course, to keep an eye on the tires. And we've got to replace the trailer tires. And here we are at Goodyear tires. And we've got a deal on the tires and some nice better tires and what's on there. And so Brenda's just pulling up in front of their workshop area. They've assigned us to be, and they say they're going to take about an hour to do the tire change, and we'll be good. We've come to the cheese factory, which is a farm. We're going to go look at the store. cows all milked by a robot. And for those of you who shall pass and want to know about the voluntary milking system, the automated cow milking process, here it is. Actually, they've gone to Manitoba, but they let us stay here, and their son met us, showed us where to park, gave us the hydro, electricity, and water connections, which is great. And this is the garden. All nice and peaceful. So now I've got to decide whether to put my chairs outside here now, sit down, read a book, eat some chips, don't have any beer though, or if we should go for a recommended drive that he's telling us about, around the lake, down to the coast, to some picturesque type villages. Chicken, chicken, chicken. Chicken, chicken, chicken.